Good morning, students. I'm Dr. Seema Thakur, Assistant Professor at School of Finance and Commerce, Algoria University. So we're going to start the lecture 2 session, and the topic is concepts of financial management. And this lecture has been already started in the lecture 1. So we are going to continue this session in this class. So what are the topics we are going to cover up in this session? That is a direct representation or delegation, financial management decision, principles of financial management, four building blocks of financial management, and the concepts of financial and management accounting. So what is the objective we are going to learn in this session? That is, how the power is being delegated, what is the source, how the delegation is being conducted, how the financial decision is being taken. Second objective is this. And the third is, what are the principles need to follow in the organization? So this is the power delegation step. You can view this slide with the help of diagram. How the power is being authorized to the subordinate officer. So when coming to the delegation of authority, authority in the sense delegation of power, it will govern as from the upper to lower employee. Like gradually it will reduce step by step. That is the delegation of authority. But when we come into the accountability, like we have to give out the clarification, or if someone is answerable in that contest, from the lower to upper position will be conducted. Like you can see in the slides that if someone is answerable, the last officer who is in the field will be the project officer, will be reporting to the operational manager, and the operational manager will answer to the CEO, that is Chief Executive Officer, and the CEO will answer to the governing body. So this is the step, how you are going to answer out from lower to upper grade. But coming to the authority delegation, but coming to the power delegation, it is being distributed from the upper to the lower employee. So you can also have the content in the slides. That is, this diagram demonstrates the day-to-day financial management task delegated down through the line management structure. At the same time, the accountability process come back through the structure as people report back on progress. So this is how, when accountability is there from lower to upper, and when delegation, when distribution of power is there from upper to lower. What are the basic principles of financial management? Principle is means like, what are the rules you have to follow up? What are the inbound things that have to consider during the process of financial management, or during the process of managing all the things? So there are the basic guidelines of financial management, which is being already mentioned, or you can say every organization tends to follow all these steps. So number one is consistency, second accountability, third transparency, fourth viability, fifth integrity, and the sixth accounting standard. So coming to the point, what is consistency? Consistency use of financial policies and procedures are for efficient operation, for the efficient and effectively to manage the organization, that the form, the way, or the work need to maintain out, that consistency is to maintain out, so that every policy should be worked in a very regular manner. Second is transparency. Transparency is what basically? Organization must be open about their work. There should be a transparent in every aspect, like managing all the things, communicating process should be very transparent, like providing information about activity and plans to all stakeholders. This includes preparing accurate, complete and timely financial report. However, the transparency is being maintained in the organization, the environment will be very stable and the things will work accordingly. Now, accountability. Accountability is what? All stakeholders have the right to know how finance and other support are being used to meet your objective. If everyone is associated in the organization for any purpose, they have the right to know the things, what is going on in the organization or what is the stability or instability things is being in the platform. So everything had to be answerable. Accountability is a moral and legal duty placed on an individual, group or organization to explain how funds, equipment or authority given has been used. Now coming to viability. Viability is what? Viability means like it sounds good. It sounds very positive. There is a viability. To be financially viable, though you are studying the concepts of financial management, the term finance is associated everywhere. So viability in the concept of financial term, we'll be reading in this slide. To be financially viable, an organization's spending must be kept in balance with the money coming in, both at the operational and the strategic level. So money should be in the liquid form, like if any contingency or if any operational work comes in between, we can be able to manage out all those things in a financial matter very strengthfully. Now viability measures the organization to determine the financial continuity and security. It also determines like how financial continuity and security is being maintained in the organization. Now what is integrity? Integrity of any organization financial record and report are dependent on accuracy and completeness of the financial record. Now standard is what? Accounting standard. It should be in very simple form that could be understandable to any stakeholder. It should be managed in that form that can be acceptable all the member who is being associated with the organization. That is the accounting standard. So that the system of keeping a financial record and documentation must be of international accepted accounting standard and principles. Any accountant from anywhere around the world should be able to understand an organization financial accounting system. Now what are the four building blocks of financial management? Four building blocks, that's what? Accounting record, financial planning, monitoring and controlling. This is the four building block of financial management, that we have to maintain out the record, then we have to make out the planning and then monitoring and then controlling. This all come under the category of financial control. So coming to the point, that is accounting record. What is accounting record? Every organization must keep an accurate accounting record of its financial transaction to show how funds have been used. The record should be maintained in a proper manner, like how the or where the fund is being used. It should be in a written form. That is accounting record. Accounting record also provides valuable information about how organization is being managed and whether it is achieving its objective or not. So why we manage the accounting record? Now the financial planning. What is financial planning? Planning is basically what? It is linked to the organization's strategic and operational plan. It is linked to the organization's strategic and operational plan. Planning is all about doing the how the thing will be managed or how the thing is maintained strategically or not. This all the things is being considered in financial planning. So the budget is the cornerstone of any financial management system and it plays an important role in monitoring the use of funds. That's a field work activity. Now coming to the monitoring process. Monitoring process is what? Organization having a set of budget have kept and reconciled its accounting record in clear and timely manner. It is impossible to produce a financial report for all stakeholders. Monitoring in the sense, whatever the information is being kept in the organization, it should be monitored or can say we have to see out the thing, whatever the thing is being maintained, whether it's in proper manner or not, whether it's according to the process or according to planning, whichever the plan is being framed out during the project. Now the internal budget monitoring report helps organization to monitor the progress of project, and annual financial statement provide accountability to external stakeholder. So we're going to define this manner also, what is financial monitoring. Now coming to the financial and management accounting, what is financial and management accounting? Though we are managing out the financial term or financial accounting, why do we manage out the management accounting? What is the main difference between the financial and management accounting? So we're going to see in this slide. For the financial management to take place efficiently, financial system and procedure need to cover two aspects of accounting, that is financial accounting and management accounting. Now what is financial accounting? Accounting is the method of recording, classifying and summarizing information for various purposes. It is also the procedure used to keep a track of financial and monetary transactions. Financial record can be maintained using manual or computerized system, that can be both. The main output of financial accounting is the annual statement used primarily for external accountability, that is the auditor function. Now coming to management accounting. Management accounting takes the data gathered by the financial accounting process, compare the result with the budget, and then analyze the information for decision making and control process. Management accounting are primarily for internal use and should be produced in a regular and timely basis, usually monthly or quarterly, depending on the need of the organization. So, in a very simple language, we coming to the concept like financial and management accounting. Financial accounting, can say it is maintained after the completion of the financial year. But for the management accounting, we have to manage out all those activities on a day-to-day basis. So the financial accounting is not compatible to give the information on the regular basis. So the management accounting is being maintained. Where the financial accounting was lacking to give out the information, so the management accounting comes under the condition, or can say that it is the basic reason for the evaluation of management accounting. So you can differentiate according to the points, whichever the things is being mentioned in the slide, that it record a transaction, and management accounting compare a result against a goal. It financial accounting classify a transaction, but management accounting determine a reason for variation. Financial accounting reconciles a record, but management accounting helps identify corrective action. Financial accounting summarize a transaction, but management accounting provide a forecast. Financial accounting present the financial data, but management accounting analyze those information. This is the basic difference between financial accounting and management accounting. Now coming to the conclusion that we already have in the lecture 1 and lecture 2. So how we are going to conclude this session? Many people have the impression that the financial management is just about the keeping accounting record, but it is an important part of program management and must not be seen as separate activity left to financial staff. This is how we are going to conclude this session. And also this is the reference which I already have mentioned in the previous slide, previous lecture, lecture 1, that is Khan and Jain Financial Management and Himalaya Public publishing house of HR. You can find the content which are already mentioned in these slides. And we are going to end this topic over here. And if you students find any problem during this lecture or during this session, you can come and get it clear to me directly. Thank you for watching. Thank you all.